Hi, Sally. Yes,
Hi.
good evening, Sally.
How are you today?
Okay, good evening.
Yeah, good evening, you too.
Okay, how are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Okay, what's the weather in Vietnam right now? It's very hot.
No, it's rain.
Okay, in my country, it's very hot. Actually, very hot. But it is actually very hot. Yeah, okay. So today let us have unit 8. Okay, we have the word
Looter.
looter. Okay, it means a person who steals things from shops or building. Okay, after riots, after fire, after flood, you will go in to steal money. Okay, next one, we have the word
Balaclava.
balaclava. It's a type of hat made of wool that covered most of the head. It's balaclava. Okay, another one, we have steering wheel. Okay, the one that the driver used, Sally, steering wheel. Next is strap. It's a narrow piece of leather cloth or other material that is used to fasten something, carry something, or hold onto something. Next is subway, an underground railway system in a city. It's a subway. Another one. Hey, lean, it means to bend or move. Bend or move from straight position. Bend or move from straight position. Ilalay natin. Okay, next. Smash, it means to break something. Smash, it means to break something. Okay, I will smash the window. Okay, smash. Smash the window violently. Next one, we have the word pony. Tail. Okay, this one. This one.
Ponytail. Plait.
Plot. This one. A plot. Okay, another one. We have the word
mustache.
Mustache. Okay. Ponytail, plot, and mustache. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Okay, are you familiar now? Look at this one. Okay, listen, ha? Look at this one, the photo. Look at the photo of Luthing and make deductions based on what you can see. Use must or can't. How do you know that?
I know that the looters don't want people to recognize them because they're wearing the mask and the hoodie too. They want
Hey,
anyone
how do you
to
know
know.
that the looters don't want people to recognize them? Because look at them. Look what they're wearing. They are
Wearing hoodies and wearing
correct. They are
a
wearing hoodies
mask
and
and a mask and mask.
jackets. Yes. Correct. Okay, next one. Okay. How do you know it's a clothes store?
Because one of the looters is holding a jeans or some kind of clothes, and it doesn't, and it have a magnet.
Wait, Ali, ha?
Wait.
Okay, how do you know that it's a clothes store? Okay, I will go
Because one of
to
the looters is holding
the
a jeans. Maybe they're looting the jeans.
They're losing the
And
jeans, yeah.
the jeans
As
still have the price on it.
correct, you can see that they're losing jeans. Okay, a pair of jeans. How do you know that it's happening during the day?
Because the sky and the light is looking. It's look bright, and I know that it's day. And if the during the day, the peoples will gather around more than night.
You can see that it's sunny. It's during the day because it's light. Okay, you can see the boy wearing a cap. Okay, now look at this one. Choose one photo and describe it to your teacher. Use the words below to help you.
I
Which
choose
photo do you like to describe about?
photo number. I choose photo B.
Okay, B,
There,
okay.
the man is stealing a handbag, a woman's handbag, and just run away without thinking.
And then
Woman looks
stealing a
shocked.
handbag, letter B, stealing a handbag, and
Yeah, someone's pulling on a handbag.
A. How about letter C? What can you say about the picture in letter C?
In the picture, let us see. There is a man is out. It's outside the car window, but he just leaned in the car to get the handbag.
Okay. So which do you think is the worst? Letter B or letter C?
I think it's the letter. I think both is it's I think the I think both is weird because in the handbag there is a money, a wallet, a charger, and some of our important things. So it was weird to one. So I decided to choose two.
Hey.
And what?
Okay, choose one photo and describe it to your teacher. Use the words below to help you.
Okay, I choose picture, picture letter E, letter D.
Letter D. Okay, please describe the hair and the accessories that the boy is doing.
This is a man. He has a mustache. He's when he has a he has curly hair or wavy hair. I don't know because I didn't see it. of the head, because he wear a hat. He has sunglasses and a scarf. And he doesn't have a ponytail. That's all.
Okay. Listen to a candidate comparing the photo from task two. Okay, so you already described me, letter B and letter C, and B are part of the, what you call as, it's not actually looting, it's some kind of, okay, wait, wait, huh? Some kind of rob, it's a robbery. Okay,
yeah, it's
so,
kind of rough.
Okay, do you agree with your final opinion? Why and why not? Okay, after you do this, kindly write your opinion, Sally, in the chat box and tell me why, okay?
Well, teacher, I think I should say.
Okay.
I can say.
Lesson 8G, exercises 4 and 5.
The first photo shows a man snatching a bag from a woman while she's walking through a subway. She's trying to hold on to the bag so he can't steal it. In the second photo, a man is leaning into a car through a broken window. He's also trying to steal a lady's bag. The common theme in the photos is crime. You can see the criminal in both photos. But unlike the first photo, the second photo does not show the victim. That's because the owner of the car is probably not there. Another obvious difference is that the criminal in the first photo might not succeed. The woman might hold on to her bag. But in the second photo, it seems as if he's definitely going to get the bag. Both photos show types of street crime, but I think the first photo shows a more worrying kind of crime. The first photo shows a crime against a person, whereas the second photo shows the theft of some property.
Okay. I think I agree with the final opinion, because the man in the picture's letter B, he's stealing a woman's bag, and she was able to hold it. So he have like 50%.
He has
to face to face with the problems. If he steal the handbag, succeed. He will 100% he succeed. But in second picture, there's the owner of the car isn't there, so the thief not worrying about the owner car is coming back.
Yes, it could be.
No, I agree.
But what will you do, Sally? I will ask you. Example, you will get this woman in letter B. What will you do with that one?
This is my opinion, right?
Okay, letter B. What do you think if you will be that woman? What will you do? What can be your reaction?
In my opinion, I think I will try to hold my bag, or I'll punch him right in the face because I have Taekwondo.
Of course, you will try to hold. What if this person has a gun or a knife?
I just scream because it's a subway, and I think there's a lot of people, I guess.
Okay, you will gonna scream. Okay, it could be. You will gonna scream because somehow or someone is trying to snatch your bag. Okay, now listen again and complete the sentences with the words below.
Okay.
Okay, wait me, huh?
Lesson 8G, exercises 4 and 5.
The first photo shows a man snatching a bag from a woman while she's walking through a subway. She's trying to hold on to the bag so he can't steal it. In the second photo, a man is leaning into a car through a broken window. He's also trying to steal a lady's bag. The common theme in the photos is crime. You can see the criminal in both photos. But unlike the first photo, the second photo does not show the victim. That's because the owner of the car is probably not there. Another obvious difference is that the criminal in the first photo might not succeed. The woman might hold on to her bag. But in the second photo, it seems as if he's definitely going to get the bag. Both photos show types of street crime. But I think the first photo shows a more worrying kind of crime. The first photo shows a crime against a person, whereas the second photo shows the theft of some property.
Okay, so do you have the answer?
One more answer. I'll just try to
what naps? Hello.
Internet at the
day? What did it? Internet at the day. Mawa dere internet? Mabot siguro.
He asked, Jenna, I asked, Saksaka, and did a bomb in Mokwa na mo. Dara na. Pagbibig Saksaka?
Wait, sa tali ha. A minute, Sally.
Okay.
Okay, Sally.
Hello, Sa.
Okay, so here, please give me the answer.
Yeah, how are you today, Elsa?
Sally. Okay, do you have the answer?
Yeah,
okay,
I'm
number one.
It.
Yeah, sorry, it's my cousin. Okay, so number one.
Okay.
Yay, very good too.
Three
and like four. Difference? Five. Six. Wow, great job. Okay, Sally, you're very good at this already. I wonder how old are you, Sally, by the way?
Okay.
Sally, how old are you now?
I'm ten.
Okay, you're in grade 9? I know, no. Grade 5?
Next year I will be in grade 5.
Okay, grade 5. Wow. At least you're in grade 5 already. Okay. Next one. Okay. So look at the sentences in task 4 again. Which one, okay, you write your answer in the chat, huh? Which one is describe similarities? Which describe differences? You write S and you write D. Okay. You write S if it's similarity and write D if it's different.
I'm finished, teacher.
Okay. So we have here, let us check. Ah, purple differences, yellow similarity. Okay. Then, okay, similarity, yellow, very good. Similarity. Okay, very good. Okay, yeah. The common theme in the photo is crime. You can see the criminal in both photos. Correct, there's similarity. Yay. But unlike the first photo, the second photo does not show the victim, its differences. Another obvious difference is that the criminal in the first photo might not succeed, its difference. Okay. Both of the photos shows type of street crime, so similarity, they have similarity. Okay. The first photo shows a crime against a person, whereas the second photo shows the thief of some property. So you can see here differences. So whereas, so they try to, what they call that one, they try to compare. Okay, similarity, both photos, okay, what are, you can see criminal in both photos. The common theme, similarity. You can see the word similarity if it's started with two of the pictures, both of the pictures, what is common of the pictures, like that, Sally. But here, but if you use but, okay, another difference, okay. The first photo, whereas the other one, okay, that is differences. I know you're very good with this. Ita, I will open the doggy. It's outside the book. Okay, so here, Sally, you read the examiner's questions and the candidate's answer. Do you agree? Why and why not? Okay, please tell me if you're done reading and you have opinion about this.
While I read the examiner's questions and the candidate's answers, I agree with the candidate's answer. Because, yeah, book Larry, it's probably worse than looting. Because when they loot from a shop, they don't stole our things, but when they burglar and in our house, we were terrified, and the burglars would stole our important things, even money and phones. So,
can you see my screen now?
In my opinion, I agree with her.
Okay. Now
okay.
Let's discuss
about. So you agree? Okay, it is really too. It's worse because it affects ordinary people, maybe families with children. If burglars broke into my house, I would be terrified. Looting from shop is a crime, but it doesn't frighten people in the same way. What is more, the looters aren't taking anyone's personal possession, so they are not upsetting anyone. Okay, so but of course, even though it's looters, it's burglars, still it's very scary, okay, because you have to get into your house or maybe into some building to get something. And if you try to stop them, of course, that's the worst thing that will happen, Sally.
Okay,
it's not
so
really good at
all. The word here is bad.
Okay.
Then another word is.
So answer the questions below. Use phrases from Learn This Box in your opinion. Okay. Isali, do you have your answer? Is crime against person always worse than a property crime? What do you think of this? Okay, you tell me if you're done, huh?
Okay.
Okay? So I don't think that crime against a person is always worse than property crime. To be honest, sometimes property crime was worse than crime against a person. I suppose it's true to say that crime against a person was not worse at all because the person can hold the thing that is being robbed. Opposite, spelling of opposite with crime against a person. Property crime can be more worse because when the crime happened, the victim can't be there and the robber could stole everyone. Okay, so yeah, you are you have the point that sometimes property crime is worse than crime against person. But of course, actually, Sally, we have different problem with the crime. So many random problem when we talk about criminals. When we talk about crime, it's random. Okay. So, Sally, compare and contrast photos A and B, then answer the questions. What do you think? What can you say A and B? What is this?
Very good. That's right. I know about Anna's bedroom. What color? Very good, Elsa. Next, how about number 5?
Teacher, where are the questions?
Hey, wait me, huh? How do you think the person is feeling and why?
I think the person is feeling bad about the day. He robbed and he broke people's. I think he feel bad because he stole and do something like a thief and a burglar. And I think he's regretting his situation.
What are the pros, the positive, and the negative of punishing criminal in this way, in your opinion? In what the pros, what the pro and the cons in punishing criminals?
I think the pros punishing criminals in this I need to read slower.
Okay, what are the negative and positive in punishing? Example like this. I'm a thief and a burglar. So do you think this is effective for a criminal?
I think the pros will punish them. Punish the man in the picture A, because if they just forget about it and let him be free and live a new life, he will continue to be a thief and a burglar. And that's the con.
Answer for number 7.
Okay, so that's it. Okay, yeah, it could be. Okay, so actually there are people, actually this not that effective because there are people who doesn't, how do you say that one, even though you were going to put like this, but it's not effective for them unless they will be in prison. Being prisoner is the best way to deal this kind of prison because they keep on doing that over and over again. Okay, so I don't know in Vietnamese, in Vietnam, if you have things like this, are there many thieves or burglars?
What else?
There are a lot, and there's killers too.
Very good. So these are the examples Okay.
So thank you, Sally, for today. Great job, Sally.
Thank you, you too. And
I will see you on Monday. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, good night.
Good night,
miss.